Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I'm not gonna be doing a tech review. I'm gonna be doing a shaving review. What am I gonna be using? Well, let me show you over here. I'm gonna show you real quick. All right, let me see how best can I do this. So today we're gonna be using the, this is a R41 head. Right here, that's the open comb. And this is a West Coast shaving handle, the little fat one, I don't know. It's really hefty. It kind of has a good weight. Sterling frozen tundra right over here, and the Wilkinson Gillette Wilkinson sword saloon pack right there. So I'm gonna be using these ones over here, the Tires Witch Hazel, and the Allen block. I just washed them, so there's gonna be a little pot of water. That's normal. So let's go ahead and take one out. Really careful because these are sharp. Alright, so first things first, we gotta make some lather with the Sterling Frozen Tundra. So I'm just gonna get out my bowl real quick. What I do is with a little half a teaspoon, I grab a half a teaspoon of soap, Sterling soap. That's how it is, nice and pink. And what I like about this one is that it's really thick. It offers a lot of protection, and that's beneficial, especially if you're gonna be taking out, you know, a couple of days of facial hair. So I just place this in the middle. I kind of like pushing it and squishing it like that. The brush, you know, can get a little bit more of it and make even more lather. So just keep going at it until it spreads out a bit. I'm just gonna wash my hands real quick. Now, got the Omega Badger brush right there. Just gonna soak it in hot water. After I soak it in hot water, I put a little bit of water in the bowl, just a tiny bit, I don't know if you guys can appreciate it. Just a little bit of water and start, you know, lathering up. This is high quality, like artisan soap, so it takes a while to lather. I would say maybe a couple minutes. I'm just gonna put a little bit more water. The Sterling soap uses a little bit more water than your average Pro Raso or barbershop quality dialer. This is premium right here. This is not your cheap stuff. But it's not also too expensive. The Sterling Frozen Tundra usually just costs about $15 or $16. And they run sales all the time. So you can see it's nice and creamy. So this is not the type of lather that, you know, like overflows your bowl, but it is really nice and really creamy, like honey. The consistency is nice, good viscosity, just like honey. What kind of bowl is this? This one I got from AliExpress. Cost me about $10 on AliExpress, but if you get like an original artisan version here in the States, it'll easily cost $30. So my suggestion is get a generic one. There's no, you know, no big deal. No need to make a big fuss about brands. Not really significant. Ooh, that's nice. Really nice. All right. So now I'm gonna apply the pre-shave. This one I use Pro Raso. Really good quality. It's a nice green tea smell. So the more pre-shave you use, the more protection you have, so make sure you're very thorough. Alright, so now I'm gonna go ahead and take off my glasses. Start applying the lather. So the good thing about Badger, you could do a little bit of exfoliating, you know, really nice and smooth. So I like to do first an exfoliation phase. You really want to pamper your face. Then I want to grab a little bit more and make sure I apply a very thick coat. Can start to grab the blade and start shaving.
Forgot my sideburns over here. I wish I could do a little bit more lather over here. Now we're going across the grain. Alright, so now I think I'm done. I'm just gonna wash up my face a little bit and check if I have like remaining, you know, little stubbles here and there. Alright, so I do have a little bit over here. A bit over here. 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 And here. So I'm just gonna go specifically into those areas because I don't wanna do too many passes and then get cut. Looks like I got a little weeper over there, but that's why we got the Allen buckhorn. So let's go ahead and use it. Let's continue. So yeah, looks like I got a couple weepers. Always happens a lot when it's been a couple days I don't shave. Something you could do to prevent this is you could use a little bit of more exfoliation to soften up the hairs. Maybe like a fake exfoliation or something. Me, I'm just gonna declare it a shave and that's it right now. I'm gonna use a little bit of the witch hazel. I'm and I wash up the soap and then throw a little bit of witch hazel. I kind of like to use the witch hazel as an aftershave.
Alright, folks, so for aftershave, there's actually a couple options. We could use, you could just leave it like that if you're comfortable. You can also use your Purazzo pre-shave as an aftershave. This is a great option. Recommend this for pre-shave for beginners. I could actually use my own Purazzo aftershave, but I'm not going to. I kind of found better results using just the unscented witch hazel as aftershave. And now there's a little bit of air, so it dries. What this is going to do, the aftershave is gonna kill any remaining bacteria in your pores so you don't break out and you don't get like bumps or anything like that. So yeah, I was able to get a nice baby but smooth shave with minimal cuts. It's inevitable to get cuts, especially when it's been a couple days. You know, that's roughly like 2 weeks of facial hair, so it's normal. Anyways, thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll do more shaving reviews in the future, so hopefully you'll see me in the next one. Thank you, goodbye.